वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैथ्स पार्ट फर्स्ट एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लेसन नंबर 3 पॉलिनोमियल्स। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय पॉलिनोमियल? पॉलिनोमियल इज एन अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन इन विच पावर ऑफ अ वेरिएबल इज होल नंबर। For example, this is a polynomial 3x raised to 4 plus 2x raised to 3 plus 5x plus 10. In this polynomial, x is a variable. This is a coefficient of x raised to 4. Coefficient of x raised to 4 is a 3. Coefficient of x raised to 3 is a 2. Coefficient of x is a plus and this is a constant term 10. Then this polynomial is in variable x and every variable has a power whole number. This x has a power 4, 4 is a whole number. This x has a power 3, 3 is a whole number. This x has a power 1, 1 is a whole number. And this x, this 10, 10 can be written as a 10 into x raised to 0. So this 0 is also whole number. Therefore, this is a polynomial. So algebraic expression in which power of a variable is a whole number is called as a polynomial. Now let's see 4y cube plus 5 upon y plus 3. This term phi upon y can be written as phi into y raised to minus 1. Now let's see, this y has a power minus 1. Phi upon y is equal to phi into y raised to minus 1. And this y has a power minus 1, which is not whole number. Therefore, this is not polynomial. So if variable is a x, then we write that polynomial as a p of x. If variable in algebraic expression is a y, then we write that polynomial as a p of y. Let's see, p of y is equal to y square plus 2y plus 3. Here the variable is a y. So this y has a power 2, this y has a power 1. And this 3 has a power 0, because 3 is equal to 3 into y raised to 0. 3 is equal to 3 into y raised to 0. So this y has a power 0. 0 is a whole number. Therefore, all the terms in this expression has a power whole number. Therefore, this is a polynomial. Now the polynomial having constant number is called as a constant polynomial. For example, 5, 3, 0, minus 5 are the constant numbers. Therefore, these are called constant polynomials. Now types of polynomials. Types of polynomials based on number of terms. If any polynomial contains only one term, that polynomial is called as a monomial. The polynomial containing the two terms is called as a binomial, and polynomial containing the three terms is called as a trinomial. Let's see, 5x square minus 7 3xy has a only one term, therefore this is a monomial. Now x raised to 4 plus 3x has a two terms, m square plus 2m has a two terms, y cube minus 3y has a two terms. Therefore, these are called binomial and trinomial. 5x square plus 5x plus 5, it has a three terms. M cube plus 3m square plus minus 9 has also three terms. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, this polynomial is called as a trinomial. So the polynomial having only one term is called as a monomial, and polynomial having two terms is called as a binomial. Polynomial having three terms is called as a trinomial. And what is mean by polynomial? Polynomial is an algebraic expression in which power of variable is whole number. So constant number such as phi 0 minus phi also polynomial that are called constant polynomial. Now degree of polynomial in one variable. When the algebraic expression contains only one variable such as 7x cube minus 5x raised to 5 plus 5x as a variable x x x, then its degree is the highest power of a variable. Let's see, this x has a power 3, this x has a power 5, and this x has a power 1. So highest power is in the term minus 5x raised to 5, that is x raised to 5. Here power is a 5, therefore degree of this polynomial is 5. So it is the highest power of a variable, is called as a degree of a polynomial in one variable. Degree of a non-zero constant polynomial is a 0. We see 25 can be read, 25 is a constant number, non-zero constant number, and it can be written as 25 is equal to 25 into x raised to 0. We know that the x raised to 0 has a value 1. This 25 can be written as 25 is equal to 25 into x raised to 0. We know that this term x raised to 0 has a value 1. Therefore, it is 25 into 1. Therefore, non-zero quantum number have a degree 0. So 25 is equal to 25 into x raised to 0, and x has a degree 0 here. Degree of a 0 polynomial not defined. 0 has a no degree. Since 0 can be written as 0 is equal to 0 into x raised to 0, and it is equal to 0 into x raised to 0 is a 1, is equal to 0. Once again, therefore we can't define the degree of the 0 polynomial. So degree of 0 polynomial is not defined. Now degree of polynomial in more than one variables. There are such algebraic expressions in which more than one variable occurs, such as x raised to 3, y raised to 6, plus 3x square y, plus 3xy square, plus y raised to 6. In all these terms, here are two variables, x and y. Here are two variables, x and y, x and y. There is one variable. So variables can be two or three. Variables are x, y, z also. Then we take a sum of the powers of both the variables. For example, x raised to 3 and y raised to 6. We take sum 6 plus 3. 6 plus 3 is a 9. Therefore, degree of this term is a 9. Now here, x square power is a 2 and y has a power 1, y raised to 1. So 2 plus 1 is a 3. Therefore, this has a degree. Let's see, this has a degree 3 and this has a degree 9. Now what is degree of this term? This x has a degree power 1 and y has a power 2. 2 plus 1 is a 3 and it has a power 6. So which is the highest power? Highest power is a 9 here. Therefore degree is a 9. It is the highest sum of powers of the variable. We take simply the sum of powers of in the variables, and that power, that is the highest power, is called as a degree of that polynomial. When the polynomials occurs more than one, that is x, y, z, m, n, in each term or in any sum of the terms, then we take the addition of the powers of two variables or powers of three variables, and that highest power is called as a degree. Here x raised to 3, 3 plus 6, 9, 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 1, 3 and 6. So highest power is a 9, therefore degree is a 9. In this way we can find degree of a polynomial in more than one variable. and degree of polynomial is one variable is highest power only, highest power of that variable x raised to pi. Pi is the highest power, so degree is equal to pi. Now let's see types of polynomial based on degree. Polynomial having only one degree is called as a linear polynomial. Polynomial having degree 2 is called as a quadratic polynomial. And polynomial having degree 3 is called as a cubic polynomial. Now let's see 5x plus 3. This x is a variable and it has a power 1. Therefore, this is linear polynomial. 21y, it has a variable y and y has a degree 1. Therefore, it is linear polynomial. Any linear polynomial can be written as in the form of ax plus b, where a and b are constant and a not equal to 0 is called as a general form of linear polynomial. Now the quadratic polynomial, polynomial having a degree 2. Let's see here, x is a variable in this polynomial and x has a degree 2. Therefore, this is a quadratic polynomial. Let's see this 7m square plus 7m plus 9 has a variable n and this m has a highest power 2. So degree of this polynomial is a 2 and therefore it is called as a quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial can be in generally written as ax square plus bx plus c, where a comma b comma c are constant and a is not equal to 0. This is called general form of quadratic polynomial. And now cubic polynomial. Polynomial having a degree 3 is called as a cubic polynomial. For example, x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 1. It has a variable x, and the highest power of variable here is a 3. Therefore, degree of this polynomial is a 3. And therefore, it is also called a cubic polynomial. Once again, 5y cube plus 9y square plus 11y plus 7. It is a polynomial in variable y. That polynomial can also be written as p of y. And the highest power of y is a 3. Therefore, this is called as a cubic polynomial. General form of cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a comma b comma c comma d are the constant and a is not equal to 0. Now the next point is a standard form of a polynomial. If the terms of a polynomial are written in descending powers of its variable, then the polynomial is called standard form of polynomial. Here is the one polynomial given p of x, variable is x, therefore we write p of x. P of x is equal to x minus 3x square plus 5 plus x raised to 4. Now this polynomial we can write as highest power at first, that is x raised to 4. Then minus 3x square, then x plus 5. Thus we have written this polynomial as descending order of powers, first as highest power, then second power, and it has a one power, that is 1, x raised to 1. If we write any polynomial in this way, that is descending order of its powers, then it is called as a standard form. It is called as a standard form. Now index form of a polynomial. If the terms of a polynomial are written in descending power of its variables, including the missing terms. If we have x raised to 4 first term and second term is given x raised to 3, then x raised to 3, and third term is given 5. Then x square and x, these terms are missing terms. If we have given y raised to 4 first term and y raised to 2 second term, then y raised to 3 is a missing term. So if we write a polynomial with its missing terms, then it is called as an index form of a polynomial. Now let's see y raised to 5 plus 3y raised to 3 plus 2y plus 5. This is a standard form of a polynomial. Because this y has a highest power 5, then decreasing order, y raised to 3, then decreasing order, ascending order, y raised to 1. So the powers of variables are in descending order. But let's see, y raised to 5, then the term of y raised to 4 is a missing there. Then there is a term y raised to 3, and y raised to 2 term is missing, and there is a term y. So if we write the polynomial with its missing terms, now let's see, this polynomial is in the variable y, therefore we write p of y. First term we write y raised to 5, then we have to term y raised to 4, but there is a no term y raised to 4, so we write that term 0 into y raised to 4. Now there is a term 3y cube, so we write 3y cube plus, there is a no term of y square, therefore we write here 0 y square, and there is a term of y plus 2y plus 2y plus 5. This form is called as the index form. Here we write all the terms in descending order, missing terms also we write, and while writing a missing term we take a 0 as a coefficient. Here y raised to 5, then directly y raised to 3 is a term, so y raised to 4 term is a missing here, therefore we write here y raised to 4. Then 3y cube is given, and then directly given 2y, so y square term is missing here, so we write here 0 into y square plus 2y plus 5. Such a type of a polynomial is called as a index form. Therefore this is a index form, this is index form of a polynomial. So at first we write the given polynomial in its standard form, then we write that polynomial in index form. And what is mean by coefficient form of a polynomial? If the coefficients of variables including the missing terms in standard form of a polynomial are written in brackets separated by commas, then the polynomial is called coefficient form. Let's see here, p of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 8. This is already in the standard form because the powers of variables are written in the descending order. Here power is a 3, then we take 2. This is standard form. And we have to write this polynomial at first in its index form. So in index form we write the missing terms. Here first term is a x cube minus, second term is a 3x square. Now there is a term x is a missing, therefore we write here 0x. There is no term of x in this form, therefore we write 0x minus 8. So it is a, this is a index form, this is called as a index form, this is a standard form, so this is index form. Now coefficient form, how to write the coefficient form? In coefficient form we write only coefficients of the terms in index form. we write at first that polynomial in index form, and we write the only coefficient of the terms in index form in bracket, then that form is called as a coefficient form. Let's see here, coefficient of x cube has a no coefficient given, but there is always one. X cube means one x cube, so we write here coefficient 1 at first term. Then let's see the term x square has a coefficient minus 3, therefore we write the second number minus 3. Then the term x has a coefficient 0, that is missing term, we added that term 0x, and x has a coefficient 0 here, and the last term is a minus 8, therefore we write here minus 8 in the bracket, in the round bracket. And the order of numbers which are written in the round bracket is very important. We write the coefficient of the term which has the highest power at first, then by descending order of powers we write the coefficients of that term and separated by comma in a round bracket, then this is called as a coefficient form of a polynomial. Now take one more example to understand this concept better. Suppose we have given one polynomial p of x is equal to 5 into x raised to 4 plus 3x square plus 5. This polynomial is in its standard form. Now let's write this polynomial in its index form. In index form we write the missing terms. Now 5 into x raised to 4 is a given term. Now let's see, there is a not term of x raised to 3, therefore we write here 0 into x raised to 3. Then there is a term of 3x square, there is a term missing x, therefore we write 0x plus 5. This is called as the index form, this is a standard form, this is index form. And lastly the coefficient form is equal to, that coefficient form is written in the round bracket. At first we write 5, then we write 0, then 3, then 0 and 5. This is called as a coefficient form. So polynomial has a three forms. One is a standard form, second is index form, and third is a coefficient form. So we can convert any polynomial. If we have given any form of a polynomial, we can write any other, that remaining two forms of the polynomial. Now practice set 3.1. Question number 1, state whether the given algebraic expressions are polynomials and justify. We know that an algebraic expression in which the power of variable is a whole number is called as a polynomial. Now let's see here, number 1, y plus 1 upon y is equal to y plus, this 1 upon y can be written as y raised to minus 1, therefore this y has a power 1, but this y has power minus 1, and this minus 1 is not whole number. We know that whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, such that, therefore this y has a minus 1 power, it is not whole number, therefore this is not polynomial. We have to write reason, since 1 upon y, since term 1 upon y has not power whole number, it has not power whole number, therefore it is not polynomial. Now 2 minus pi into root x, here is a variable x, so this can be written as 2 minus pi into x. Root x can be written in index form, x raised to 1 upon 2. Now this 1 upon 2 is not whole number, therefore this is not polynomial. This is not polynomial since root x has not power whole number. Number 3, x square plus 7x plus 9. Now power of x is a 2, power of this x is a 1, so this can be written as 7x square plus 7x into 1, and this 9 can be written as 9 into x raised to 0. So this x has a power 2, that is whole number, this x has a power 1, whole number, and this x has a power 0, 0 is also whole number, therefore this is a polynomial, this is polynomial. And we have to write here justification, since variable has power whole number, now number 4, 2m raised to minus 2 plus 7m minus 5, let's see, this m has a power minus 2, so minus 2 is not whole number, therefore this is not polynomial, since m raised to minus 2 has not power whole number. And number 5, 10, this 10 can be written as 10 into x raised to 0, so this is a polynomial. Because the 0 is a whole number, reason is since variable has power whole number. Now question number 2, write the coefficient m cube in each of the given polynomial. Number 1, m cube, this m cube has a coefficient, it is not given but there is a 1, so this m cube can be written as 1 into m cube, so coefficient of m cube is equal to 1. Number 2, minus 3 upon 2 plus m minus root 3 m cube, so coefficient of m cube, what is coefficient of m cube here, minus root 3. And number 3, minus 2 upon 3 एम क्यूब माइनस फाइव एम स्क्वेयर प्लस सेवन एम माइनस वन एंड वी हैव टू राइट कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एम क्यूब कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एम क्यूब इज माइनस टू अपॉन थ्री. Now question number 3, write the polynomial in x using the given information. Monomial of degree 7, here we have to use variable x and degree is the highest power of that variable and monomial means polynomial containing only one term. Therefore, its answer is variable x we have to write here and the degree is the highest power, that is x raised to 7. Now see, x raised to 7 is a one term, so polynomial having only one term is called as a monomial. So x raised to 7 is a monomial of degree 7. Now binomial having degree 35. Now here we have to write the variable x and binomial is a polynomial having a term 2, two terms. Here we use two terms and the highest power of a term is a first term is a 35, that therefore we write x raised to 35 plus you can take any term in variable x. So we write here let 7x square, you can write so many polynomial binomial having degree 35, x raised to 35 must be there and the another term you can select any other term. Now trinomial having a degree 7, trinomial means having a three terms and the highest power of a variable should be 8. Here variable we have to take x and its highest power is 8, x raised to 8. Now another two terms, you can take any two terms. So x raised to 8 plus 5x square plus 5. Your answer may be different, but in your answer x raised to 8 has power, x has a highest power 8. Now write the degree of given polynomial root 5. This root 5 can be written as root 5 into x raised to 0, so their degree is a 0. Then x raised to 0 degree is 0, then x square degree is a power, so it is a 2. Now root 2 into m raised to 10 minus 7. So variable is m and its power, highest power is a 10, therefore its degree is a 10. Then this 2p minus root 7 can be written as 2p raised to 1 minus root 7 and p has a power 1, so its degree is a 1. Now this y has a power 1, this y has a power 3, this y has a power 5, so highest power is 5, so degree is a 5 here. Then x, y, z, x has a power 1, y has a power 1, z has a power 1, so what will this 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3, so x, y, z has a degree 3. Now here 1 plus 1, 2, this xy has a degree 2 and z has a degree 1. So highest power is x plus 1 plus, sorry, 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is a 3. So degree of this polynomial is a 3. Now here m raised to 3 into n raised to 7, 3 plus 7 is a 10. Now m raised to 5, this n has a power 1, so it will be 5 plus 1, 6. Now m raised to 1, n raised to 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 5 plus 1, 6, and 3 plus 7, 10. So highest power is a 10, therefore degree is equal to 10 here. Example number 5. Classify the following polynomials in linear, quadratic and cubic polynomial. We know that polynomial having a degree 1 is called as a linear polynomial. Polynomial having degree 2 is called as a quadratic polynomial. And polynomial having degree 3 is called as a cubic polynomial. And degree is the highest power of that variable. Now let's see. This is a polynomial 2x square plus 3x plus 1. And highest power is a 2. Highest power of x is a 2. So degree is a 2. Therefore, it is a quadratic polynomial. So we write here quadratic polynomial. This 5p can be written as 5p raised to 1. So p has a power 1 means degree 1. So it is a linear polynomial. Polynomial having degree 1 is called as a linear polynomial. Now this can be written as root 2 y raised to 1 minus 1 upon 2. This variable y has a power 1, highest power is a 1. So degree is a 1. Therefore it is also linear polynomial. Next example, m raised to 3 plus 7 into m square plus 5 upon to m minus root 7. So variable is m in this polynomial and highest power of m is a 3. Therefore degree of this polynomial is a 3. Therefore it is a cubic polynomial. Polynomial having a degree 3 is called cubic polynomial. Now a square, here variable is a and degree is a 2, therefore it is quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. 3r raised to 3, variable is r and its power is a 3, therefore degree is a 3, therefore it is also cubic polynomial. Now question number 6, write the following polynomials in standard form. When the polynomial is written in the descending order of the powers of their variables, then they are said to be in standard form. So we have to write here standard form is equal to highest degree, highest term containing the highest power is m cube. Then descending order, that is im plus 3. Here m has a power 3, this m has a power 1. So we have written powers in descending order. So m cube plus 5m plus 3. Now number 2, standard form is equal to term containing the highest power of variable is 5 y raised to 5, then plus 2 y raised to 4, then this plus 3 y raised to 3, then this minus y square, then term of y minus 7y minus 1 upon 2. This is in standard form. Term containing highest power 5, then term containing highest power 4, then term containing power 3, then the variable containing power 2, then the variable containing power 1. And 1 upon 2 has a power 0, because 1 upon 2 can be written as 1 upon 2 into y raised to 0. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, राइट द फॉलोइंग पॉलिनोमियल्स इन द कोएफिशिएंट फॉर्म. वी राइट दैट पॉलिनोमियल इन इंडेक्स फॉर्म एट फर्स्ट एंड देन द कोएफिशिएंट फॉर्म. नंबर 1, एक्स क्यूब माइनस 2 एंड इट्स इंडेक्स फॉर्म इज इक्वल टू एक्स रेस्ट टू 3 प्लस टर्म ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर इज मिसिंग देयरफॉर वी राइट 0 एक्स स्क्वायर. टर्म ऑफ एक्स इज मिसिंग देयरफॉर वी राइट 0 एक्स माइनस 2. दिस इज इंडेक्स फॉर्म. नाउ कोएफिशिएंट फॉर्म इज इक्वल टू राइट द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ ईच टर्म. कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स क्यूब इज 1, इट हैज 1 हियर 1. कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर 0, कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स इज 0 एंड दिस माइनस 2. नंबर 2, 5y. नाउ इट्स राइट इन इंडेक्स फॉर्म दैट विल बी 5y प्लस 0. एज देयर इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म वी राइट 0. कोएफिशिएंट फॉर्म इज इक्वल टू इन ब्रैकेट कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ y इज 5 एंड दिस 0. नंबर 3, 2 इंटू एम रेस टू 4 माइनस 3 एम स्क्वायर प्लस 7. राइट दिस इन इंडेक्स फॉर्म एट फर्स्ट. सो इंडेक्स फॉर्म इज इक्वल टू 2 इंटू एम रेस टू 4. टर्म ऑफ एम क्यूब इज मिसिंग देयरफॉर वी राइट 0 इंटू एम रेस टू 3 माइनस 3 एम स्क्वायर. टर्म ऑफ एम इज मिसिंग therefore we write 0 m plus 7. Now coefficient form is equal to write coefficients in bracket 2 0 minus 3 0 7. So we write coefficients only 2 0 minus 3 0 7. Number 4, minus 2 upon 3, it is a constant polynomial, so its a coefficient form is that number only, minus 2 upon 3. Question number 8, write the polynomials in index form. Number 1, 2, 3. Here number of coefficients is equal to 3. Number of coefficients 1, 2, 3. So we find degree of polynomial is equal to 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. So degree is a 2 here. Now we write index form. Index form is equal to, we write at first coefficient 1 into variable x into raised to its power 2. Degree is a 2, therefore we take 2 here. Then we write second coefficient 2 variable x and degree is a 1. That is in descending order. And then we write a quantum term 3. So 1 into x square is x square plus 2x plus 3 is its index form. Now number 2, 5, 0, 0, 0, minus 1. So number of coefficients. Number of coefficients 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So degree is equal to degree of a polynomial is equal to 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. We subtract 1 from the number of coefficients to find degree. So degree is a 4. Now Now write index form. At first we write this quantum term, quantum phi, then variable x. You can select any other variable such as y, m, n. We write at first quantum term phi, variable x, and we take power 4, that is a degree. Then we take the next number 0, then variable x and degree 3. Then we take third number 0, then variable x and its power 2. Then we take the next number 0 and variable x and its power 1. And we write at last the constant term minus 1 is equal to phi into x raised to 4. 0 into x cube is 0, 0 into x square is 0, 0 into x raised to 1 is a 0. Therefore, we write the last phi into x raised to 4 minus 1. This is called as a standard form also. Now, number 3, minus 2, 2, minus 2, 2. Number of coefficients. Number of coefficients 1, 2, 3, 4. So what will be degree now? 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So degree of a polynomial is equal to 4 minus 1 is a 3. Degree is a 3. Now write index form is equal to, at first write the first coefficient minus 2, then write variable x, and then degree is a 3, therefore its power 3. Then we write second coefficient plus 2, variable x, and then degree write then write its power 2. Then the third coefficient minus 2, variable x, and power 1. And the last as a constant number plus 2. So this will be minus 2x cube plus 2x square minus 2x plus 2. It is index form of the coefficient. So we can convert the coefficient form into its index form in this way. Question number 9. Write the appropriate polynomials in the boxes. Here we have given different polynomials and we have to write that particular polynomial in the given boxes. The first is a binomial. So what is mean by binomial? Is a polynomial having a two terms. So x plus 7 is binomial. Then this x cube plus 9, x cube plus 9 is also binomial. So 3x square plus 5x is a binomial. So binomial is a polynomial containing two terms, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, two terms. Trinomial. Trinomial is a polynomial containing three terms. So this polynomial has a three terms. 2x square plus 5x plus 10. This has a three terms, therefore it is trinomial. Now monomial. Monomial is a polynomial containing only one term. This is x square. X square is a monomial. There is only one monomial. Now, quadratic polynomial. This is according to the degree. This is classification according to the degree. This is classification according to the terms. Quadratic polynomial. Polynomial having a degree 2. X square. Then here degree 3, in this term degree is a 2. So 2x square plus 5x plus 10 has a degree 2 because highest power of polynomial is 2. So degree is a 2. And last one, 3x square plus 5x. It has also x has highest power 2. And if power of 2 is a power is a 2, then it is called as a quadratic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. Polynomial having degree 3. Degree 3. This polynomial. X cube plus x square plus x plus 5. Since highest power of x is a 3, therefore it is cubic polynomial. Here also highest power of x is a 3. Therefore x cube plus 9 is also cubic polynomial. Now linear polynomial. Linear polynomial is polynomial having degree 1. That is x degree has a 1. Therefore x plus 7 is a linear polynomial.